You talk about the symbol of American success. There was a the storm hit people differently if they were rich or poor. Did you see that?
Yeah, in the aftermath, I think the first thing in regards to that is how people were able to evacuate or not evacuate. Some 100,000 people in New Orleans did not have access to a vehicle. So the evacuation plan was great for folks that had a vehicle and could get out, but so many people didn't have access, and a lot of the buses that were supposed to come to pick up people to get them out never showed up. So a lot of folks in the poor communities weren't able to get out. And also, of course, the elderly, disabled. That was the biggest problem with the evacuation process.
Now, you have kept going back. What have you seen?
I tell you what, every time I go back, it gets a little bit better. There's just an increment that's notched up each time. The last time I was down there, the joy and the spirit and the energy of New Orleans really has recovered, and there's no one that can't deny that.
Would you normally have gone back to a big story that you've covered, or is there something special about New Orleans that drew you back?
It really was something indescribable. I came back to New York. I had ridden on the boats with some of these folks. I was in the Superdome, and I really couldn't get them out of my head. I can't really describe it. And I just felt like I had to go back down there and see what was happening and see if folks were coming back. And every time I went down, I started to see the same people and see the spirit rebuilding. It was infectious. And you just wanted to document this time in American history, this incredible attempt at renewal and rebirth.
You've also covered, you've been to Iraq and Afghanistan and covered those stories. Similarities, differences?
The most similar thing that I can remember is when the cavalry finally arrived, the American DOD came in, I think 4 days, 5 days later, started doing airdrops, started doing helicopter rescues, and you had helicopters flying all over the city, landing on highways, picking up people off highways. That reminded me of Iraq. It looked like Iraq, or it looked like old photos I had seen of Vietnam. In those first few days, when there was no relief, no supplies coming in, when people basically, it felt like a failed state for a few days. So in those ways, it reminded me of Afghanistan a bit.
And do you think if this happened again, what would the reaction be like in New Orleans?
I think they'll be a lot more prepared this time. I think it seems like there'll be a lot more coordination between agencies and I think people will take it a lot more seriously. But it's so hard to imagine that happening again, God forbid. Unfortunately, history suggests it probably will sooner or later.
All right, Mario Tama, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you, John. My pleasure.